Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. Recently, OPPO released the Find X5, which is equipped with an 80W SuperVOOC charger. And today we're going to take apart this charger to see what components are inside. It adopts a white plastic shell and printed with 80W SuperVOOC. The slight hollows on two sides can facilitate the user to hold it more tightly. The prongs cannot be folded, and let's see the specs info. Model is VCB8JACH. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2 amp, and output of 5 volts, 2 amp, 5 to 11 volts, 7.3 amp. There is a special metal contact inside the USB-A port for higher current. The size of the charger is 55, 54, and 31 mm. Weight is about 100 grams. Compared with Apple 87W charger, the size is much smaller. The charger led power ZKT002 shows it supports Samsung 5V, 2A, DCP, VOOC, Dash, Warp, and SuperVOOC protocols. The next step is to take it apart and check what components are inside this charger. Use the spudger to pry along the gap. It doesn't work. Let's switch to the cutting machine. After opening it, we found the fixed prongs are connected to PCB through red and black wires. Take out the module and discharge the PCB. The gaps between the front components are filled with silicon adhesives, the filter capacitor is covered with white film, and the metal heatsink and black insulating plate are on the back. ChargerLab found it adopts the typical QR topology, and the protocol chip can control the output voltage. Let's introduce all components one by one from the inputs. Firstly, the current will pass through the fuse. The Walter input time delay fuse is 2.5 amp, 250 volts. The NTC thermistor is wrapped with heat shrinkable tube and can suppress the inrush current. The diameter is 11 mm. And then is the EMI filter circuit composed of the common mode choke and X capacitor. Two common mode chokes are also covered with heat shrinkable tubes and can suppress EMI interference. The X capacitor is from Matsuda, 0.1 microfarad. After the EMI filtering, the bridge rectifier is from Yangjie and can convert AC into DC, 8 amp 1000 volts. Those two filter capacitors are from Acon, which can filter out the pulsed DC, 400 volts, 33 microfarad. This is differential mode filter inductor wrapped with heat shrinkable tube. The mass control chip is from Power Integrations SC1738C, the customized model. It integrates quasi resonant feedback controller and primary MOSFET. It can dynamically control the output voltage and current. The capacitor that powers the mass control chip is from Koshin, 50 volts, 10 microfarad. The transformer is wrapped with insulating tape marked with VCB8HM. Two blue-white capacitors are connected in series to meet the safety requirements. And then the current from transformer will filter out by solid capacitor after synchronous rectification. The synchronous rectifier is from AOS AON6220, which adopts DFN5×6 package, 100 volts, 6.2 milliohm. The NTC2 thermistor in the upright corner detects the internal temperature. A Schottky diode is connected in parallel with synchronous rectifier used to improve the efficiency of synchronous rectification. The protocol chip is the customized model with OPPO by Injoinic, which can support the SuperVOOC protocol. The output VBUS MOSFET is from Pingwei and adopts DFN5×6 package, 30 volts, 5.5 milliohm. Two output solid capacitors are from PolyCap RQ series, 680 microfarad, 16 volts. Finally, here is the USB-A receptacle, which is equipped with extra contacts for higher current. Well, that's all components of this charger. As the original charger comes with the mobile phone, its quality is okay, but its compatibility with many mobile phones from other brands is not very good. Because the USB-A output port makes it unable to support the USB PD protocol, so it's most suitable for users who use OPPO phones. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!